Water-saturated land, wetlands, only cover around 6% of the Earth's land area, but roughly 40% of our planet's wildlife depends on freshwater wetlands for its habitat. These ecosystems are also vital for humans, as they are the world's largest carbon sink. Yet today their existence is threatened. One reason is that they're located next to the floodplains, which are also the most favored areas for rice cultivation. These two worlds coexist in the delta of one of Spain's largest rivers, the Ebre. The Ebre is also the longest river in Catalonia. Its delta, located in the southern region of Catalonia, is an important economical and agricultural hub. The water that flows across the delta is diverted from the Ebre River, north of the city of Amposta, in the form of an irrigation canal. The canal then spreads into a network of 700 kilometers of smaller irrigation canals that distribute the water.
It is important to control irrigation water and rice cultivation. Given the characteristics of the land we have here, it needs a lot of water. We are consuming 18,000 cubic meters per hectare easily.
22,000 hectares of rice fields receive this irrigation water, producing 140 million kilos of rice every year. The runoffs from the rice fields are carried by numerous channels that enter the sea at multiple points along the shoreline. The aquaculture industry along the coast of the Ebre Delta is highly dependent on the fresh water coming out of the rice fields. Up to 3,400 tons of mussels and 300 tons of oysters are harvested here annually.
We know that 1 cubic meter of fresh water renews 10 cubic meters of seawater in the bay with nutrient inputs and high water quality. The sea benefits from irrigation water.
Though the fresh water is highly beneficial to the bay area, rice farming activities release chemicals into this water. This threatens the biodiversity of one of the most important natural parks in the Mediterranean, the neighboring 10,000 hectares of wetlands.
When we sow the rice, the field is already flooded and the temperature is already high. All the weeds in the field have already started to grow. If we left them alone, they would take over the crop and we would have no harvest.
Weeds compete for sunlight and cause the greatest yield loss in rice. They destroy about 33% of the crop. Additionally, damage caused by insects accounts for around 26% of crop loss.
Well, for these echinochloa weeds, we have already used an agrochemical once, but it is only effective when they are small plants. Then when the weeds grow and they are very large, the agrochemical does nothing to them, and you have to manually remove them, since it is important for production to have clean soil.
Here at the Ebre Delta, the rice crop is treated 2 to 3 times a year, first in May and June to hinder the weeds from growing, then again in July and August to stop fungus from spreading. Many of these chemicals end up in the water surrounding the rice. To prevent this polluted water from entering the neighboring wetlands and sea, researchers from the IMPETUS project have come up with a solution to filter the water before it leaves the rice field.
How our pilot has been designed is on a gradient of gravity. So what the rice field does, actually, it's filled from one side and through a very, very gentle slope, the water flows to the exit, right? So before this exit, this discharge, we want to build these smaller cells, which is filled with some materials.
All the test materials are nature-based absorbents. These cells form an artificial wetland at the end of the test field. Just in the natural wetlands, when water enters these cells, it will slow down, which allows the plants and soil in the cell to absorb a significant amount of pollutants, enabling a large volume of water flowing through the test site to be filtered. The IMPETUS project attempts to find out the most suitable soil or nature-based substance for filtration. These materials were selected at the laboratory of Eurocat in Manresa.
The pesticides and herbicides are solubles, so we need a media which can somehow take out from the water and keep these compounds that we want to remove from water itself.
Three different media: sand, a combination of rice husk, and a mixture of sand with biochar showed promise. The researchers pushed contaminated water from the Ebre Delta through each of them. The water that came out after passing through the media was sampled and analyzed.
After that, we were running the experiment 5 days a week. We could identify which was the best combination of these absorbents that we could then implement it into the wetland.
The mixture of biochar and sand showed about 80 to 90% of contaminant removal in laboratory tests, which were then set up in April 2023 at the IMPETUS pilot site. 9 separate test cells were filled with different absorbents, either sand, the promising mixture of biochar and sand, or control cells without any absorbents. Each cell received the same amount of water from the drainage canal. Their outputs were periodically sampled and sent to a lab for analysis.
We are doing the experiment in here because we are not far from the drainage canal, which is where we pump the water from. It's only 20 meters away from here. This is the drainage canal, which is the one that gets the water coming out from the rice field.
A drainage canal is the channel that carries water leaving the rice fields. It carries the highest load of residual contaminants. Therefore, the water was used to test the filtration capacity of natural absorbents. The analysis of samples collected from this pilot experiment showed up to a 60% removal for the most common fungicides and herbicides. This experiment carried out in the open environment showed lower removal of chemicals than lab-based filtration, yet they are promising results, which will now need to be verified in real field conditions in the form of a new experiment. If successful, it would mean that each rice field could have an artificially constructed wetland cell at its outlet point before the water enters the drainage canal. This would facilitate a removal of at least 50 to 60% of pollutants that would otherwise enter the sea. This method could also be applied in other locations that use the same principles, such as other deltas in Spain or in the world.